Not here. Just behind us on your left, a white monument on the embankment wall with a golden eagle perched upon the top. This is a war memorial, and it was put there to commemorate all the brave airmen and indeed our women that lost their lives during the First and Second World Wars. It stands in front of the Ministry of Defence building. That's the white building there with the four green eagles. Still on your left, we have a building a lot of people ask about behind the trees. That's Whitehall Court Mansions, one of the first purpose-built luxury apartments on the banks of the Thames. Today there is a few apartments in there, but mainly it's the five-star Royal Four Stars Hotel. Just a nice hotel there. Ahead of the boats, the Charing Cross Railway. You may have heard us speak before. We like to wave to people on this bridge. Try and get us a wave back. There's no stopping them up there, is there? If they didn't wave back, that means they're from London. And they're visible. There's another bridge on the other side. Hello up there. City of London School of the Arts. Many famous and important people got their early education in that school. Famous people like Lord Aspen, Winston Churchill, David Beckham, and me. Of course, that wasn't true. David Beckham never went to that school. Up ahead of us, we have the Blackfriars group of bridges. The first one, a road bridge, opened in 1869 by Queen Victoria. Look at the top of the red support columns. You'll see birds engraved into the stone. Each column's different. This side of the bridge, they're all fresh water birds. On the other side of the bridge, salt water birds. This is where the Victorians believed the fresh water coming down from the source of the river, the Cotswold Hills in Gloucestershire, that the salt water would be in the North Sea. The red columns inside of the boat is all that remains from the first railway bridge thus far to the Thames, designed by Isambard King of Bluedell. If you've been on a journey anywhere in this country, then you've been home, over or through something that we've got to do, and famous in Australia. The last bridge was built to replace it, and that's known as the Blackfriars Railway Bridge. On your left here, St. Paul's Cathedral, my favourite building here in London. Opened in the year 1710. It took only 35 years to construct. It was designed by the master architect, Sir Christopher Wren. He is buried inside. The height of St. Paul's is easy to remember. It's 365 feet, 1 foot for every day of the year. Very easy to remember. And look above the dome, you'll see people up there. I've been up there 6 times in total, and I recommend it to you all. 528 stairs you climb to get to the top. Well, here's a little bit there, but the views are as good as I can imagine. I spoke to some customers who literally just got off the boat. They said they went up there this morning. It's not that busy. It'll go straight to the top as well. A large brick building with a bridge, the old Boatside Power Station. Not a power station today, now the Tate Modern Art Gallery. If you like modern art, that's the place to go. I don't think I understand modern art. I went in there, I saw a pile of bricks, a burnt out car and a half-eaten curry. There was masterpieces made from rubbish. But I also saw 10 Pablo Picasso paintings. I'd never seen one before. It was worth it for that alone. And on your right here, a white building with a thatched roof, the replica of Shakespeare's Crown Theatre. It's opened only throughout our summer month. They reenact Shakespeare's traditional plays, all played out in a traditional style. No lighting, no sound amplification, and the actors dress in a period costume. It is an open-air theatre, open to the elements. When it rains out here, it rains in there. That's why it only opens during the summer. But when it is open, they fly a red flag from the flagpole to tell us there's a performance on in the evening. You can see the flag flying, which may answer your question. Yes, this is summer. Sorry. Overhead here, the Southwark Bridge, opened in 1921. You don't see a lot of people upon this bridge. What you do is generally local people and professional clients. The approach roads are well hidden in the back streets of London, but many people find this bridge. I know we've been waiting in the area, but I'm not even waiting in the area. this area on your right is Southwark. Just ahead of your right is a little pub called The Anchor. Dates back to 1650. Many famous people have been in this pub over the years. People like Samuel Pepys, Dr. Samuel Johnson, Christopher Wren, Charles Dickens, and old William Shakespeare himself. Dr. Samuel Johnson comprised one of the first English dictionaries. He was also a diarist. Dr. Johnson is the man that once famously wrote, "If a man is tired of running, then he is tired of life itself." They are words of a very clever man. But remember, they are words of a man that has never been on our underground during the rush hour. And on your right, a pirate ship, the replica of Sir Francis Drake's ship, the Golden Pirate. Drake, he was the first English captain to circumnavigate the world, and he did so on a ship like that one, with a crew of 18. A famous bridge. Is anybody going to shout out the name of this bridge? That's it, let yourselves go. London Bridge, this is it. I don't know how you got it. It says it on the stone. Yeah, I hope it gets past you. This is the fifth London Bridge that stood here since Morgan. And yes, you are right. On the spot. So if you've got your cameras, look on your left. Take a picture. The first London Bridge was built 33 A.D. Near the top, one on the 68th floor, one on the 72nd floor. In total, that building has 87 floors. Has anybody been up there? No? They didn't have 3 days in London. They just walked up to the building, they asked at the reception, there was a cancellation, and they got to the top within an hour, free of charge. On your right here, we have the HMS Belfast, the largest light cruiser, ever commissioned by the Royal Navy, weighs 11,500 tons. Part of the Imperial War Museum today. Well worth going up there. There is right next to Explore. It's open 7 days a week. There's someone waving at you at the back there. For the way Mum and Dad is. You may know years ago, going back to Nelson's Navy, if there was ever a lady on board that was pregnant or gave birth, they didn't always know who the father was. They would call him the son of a gun. Their birth would take place at the gun then. He's known as a son of a gun. But that was unbelievable. On your right, a glass building, meant to look like something.
We've had a lot of suggestions of what people think it looks like, but no one ever gets it right. We decide pine cone or pineapple, or honeycots or a beehive, the stack of pizzas falling over, a belly of a pregnant woman, and a legless salamandilla. Someone once shouted out, that looks like a monstrous carbuncle. Yeah, I still don't know what that is. It was actually built to look like a motorcyclist crash helmet. Do you see it now? £52 million it cost to build, and no one ever guesses it was built to resemble a crash helmet. That's the head offices of the Mayor of Greater London, Boris Johnson. Tower Bridge, the gateway to London. And Tower Bridge is not as old as it looks. It was opened on June the 30th in 1894. It is a steel and iron, part suspension, part basketball bridge. It only has stone around it so that it blends in, and it does have a name that I cannot repeat on this microphone in fear of losing my job. But it's factual, historic, and you're welcome to ask me when you go. And on the river wall is a picture archway with words above it, entering to the traitor's gates. If you was a traitor to the crown and found guilty, you'd be taken through there. The tower, you had to be a friend of royalty. What a privilege. Most people taken up to Tower Hill, home drawing quarter. Not many people went into this building through Traitor's Gate, and was not wanting you to lose anything. And if anyone is getting off here, I'll sign up now. Just check your pockets, check the floor, check your pockets again. Make sure you've got all your personal belongings with you. You will be surprised how many people leave children.